This is a Collins KWM2A that I was asked to look at. This particular radio was in storage for about 40 years. It was overhauled in 1988. And it came in its transit case. And we'll open the case up and the radio sits in there. And also the crystal pack and microphone live in the transit case. Now, I've dealt with KWM2As a little bit in the past. This is my own, but it's nowhere near as nice as this radio. If you look at the inside, it's very clean. Even the things like the tube shields and everything look like they're brand new. Under the chassis, there's no discoloration, no dust or dirt. Even in the power amplifier, you'll usually see some discoloration in that stage on these radios. All the wiring is very clean. And of course, this is a KWM2A, so it's not the civilian version. It has the plug-in relays, also the Teflon wiring, and the all-important second crystal pack, which lives under the deck. The under-the-deck pack is the one that has all the ham crystals in it. The above deck is the one for the plug-ins. So it required a little bit of cleaning, and especially some of the switches and controls. There were some oxidation and issues, but nothing that was really that bad. A couple of things about the Collins is one of the things that confuses a lot of people is how to interpret frequency on it. They have a dial that goes from 0 to 200, and 0 to 200 kilohertz. If you look at the crystal pack on the radio, you just take the frequency of the crystal that you have selected and add that number to it, and that gives you the frequency. So like in this case, we're at 102, so that would actually be on 7302. Now that you know how to read frequency, let's look at calibrating a radio. Put the radio in calibrate. There is a calibration checkpoint every 100 kilohertz. What you'll do is in one sideband, zero beat the radio. Switch to the other sideband. Make sure you're in between the two. And now you know the radio is calibrated to the nearest 100 kilohertz. So we'll go ahead and align the pointer. Now we know we're at 7300 exactly. Let's look at tuning the radio. First, we'll put the meter in grid. Come over and switch the radio into the tune mode and peak the exciter. You'll go for the strongest peak on exciter. Switch the meter back to plate, go to the lock mode, and then using the PA tuning, we'll dip the plate. On one side of your dip, you'll find that's where your strongest output is. After you dip for resonance, you can make adjustments in the output power using the mic gain control. We put it back in lock for a minute. You can see that with the mic gain control, you could also affect what your output power is. Myself, after tuning the radio, I'll use the mic gain control and the ALC position on the meter to get the best overall performance. Let's go ahead and try the radio out on the bands and see how it does.
Okay, let's see. I should have the linear on now, so maybe I'm a little bit stronger up there. I could barely copy Eugene. I could make out most all of what he was saying, but it was just barely copy. So, let's see if the linear sounds okay. Back to you, Ray. KB, KH, K4, MYW.
K4NYW. I'd say you picked up three S units. A good three S units. So that's what the linear gives you. I'm assuming that's the Harris linear that goes with the 350K. Over.
Yeah, Roger. It's the 1KW version.
Let's see if Eugene can copy you. W2HX, can you copy him? Over.
W2HX. I also barely hear Nick. He's just come in you, KA3HW2HX.
Ah, number 3, KCD, I think it is. Let me go ahead and let you go on. N3 KCD, over.
Hey, 3 KCD, I heard you guys talking. Just wanted to see if I was getting in there. Running on KWM2A this morning. Fire up and see if it's talking right. Over to you, N3 KCD.
Oh, N3 KCD. And the group, this is KA3KH. You'll be interested to know that I'm talking to you on a KWM2A also. This is the 2A, the military version. And this is one which I was just talking about was in storage for 40 years after overhaul at depot. And I just recently brought this out and cleaned it up. So, it's a very nice, clean radio. It's kind of like a time capsule. You know, you rarely see them like that. Let's see, W2HX Eugene is in here with us, and K4NYW. And just want to let K4NYW know that that Eugene has been able to actually hear him a little bit, but he's still kind of in the noise level at his location up in New York. So, or I guess he's North Jersey. I don't know if he's New York. So with that, let me turn it back over to Nick, K4NYW. Over.
K4NYW, what is it? K3KH in the group. This is K4NYW. Yeah, it seems funny to be not